The SRTR public website shows five-tier outcome assessments for three metrics: survival on the waiting list, getting a transplant faster, and one-year organ survival. This video details how these five-tier assessments are calculated. SRTR developed the five-tier outcome assessment system to make it easier for the public to compare and understand the outcomes of different transplant programs. This is in alignment with reporting requirements of the Organ Procurement and Transplantation Network, OPTN, final rule, which states that OPTN and SRTR, as appropriate, shall make available to the public timely and accurate program-specific information on the performance of transplant programs. This shall include free dissemination over the internet and shall be presented, explained, and organized as necessary to understand, interpret, and use information accurately and efficiently. Also, in fulfillment of the final rule, the SRTR contractor must identify transplant programs and organ procurement organizations with better or worse outcomes. In this video, we'll describe how tiers are assigned for each of the three outcomes presented in the initial search results section of the SRTR website. We first describe how this is accomplished for the one-year organ survival outcome. A similar methodology is applied to the pre-transplant metrics, with a few differences as described later. The five-tier assessment for one-year organ survival is derived from the estimated hazard ratio for first-year graft survival, as reported in Table C6 of the Program-Specific Reports, or PSRs, for kidney and liver programs, and Table C6D for all other organs. We first estimate the program's hazard ratio for the first-year graft failure. Hazard ratio is the number of observed graft failures, plus 2, divided by the number of expected failures, plus 2. Graft survival shows how many transplants were done at a program and indicates how well they were done. In some cases, one recipient may have had more than one transplant over time, and the data reflects this. This is important because it shows all events that affect a patient's outcome. A retransplant can factor into a recipient's long-term survival as well. The hazard ratio is a measure of how many patients did not survive the first post-transplant year with a functioning graft, relative to how many were expected not to survive it. A hazard ratio of 1.0 means that we observed exactly the number of graft failures as expected at the program, after considering the types of patients and donors at that program. A hazard ratio of 0.5 means the program experienced half the failures expected. A hazard ratio of 2 means the program experienced double the number of failures expected. Estimating outcomes always involves some degree of uncertainty. Therefore, we calculate a bell-shaped curve like the one shown in Figure 1 that describes the likely location of the program's hazard ratio. A narrower bell curve indicates more certainty about the estimate. A wider bell curve indicates less certainty. Once we have an estimate of the program's hazard ratio as shown in Figure 1, we assign a score based on the location and spread of the bell-shaped curve. The location of the curve, i.e., how far it is to the left or right, tells us whether the program's failure rates are 1, likely better than expected, the curve shifts to the left of 1, or 2, worse than expected, the curve shifts to the right of 1. To assign a score to the program, we apply a score function. This function assigns more value to hazard ratio estimates less than 1, indicating better than expected performance, and less value to estimates higher than 1. This is shown here as the score curve gradually declines from left to right. Using the score function described in Step 2, we arrive at a new bell-shaped curve by applying the score function across the range of the original bell-shaped curve for the program's hazard ratio. This is done by multiplying the value of the score function by the value of the bell-shaped curve along the full range of the curve. After applying the score function to our estimate of the program's hazard ratio, as described by the bell-shaped curve, we arrive at a new bell-shaped curve. It is a result of multiplying the score function and the bell-shaped curve together. The area under this new bell-shaped curve is the program's score. But to determine the area under the curve, a mathematical equation is used that is so complex, SRTR uses a computer to run it. The final step in the process is to assign a score to tiers. Each program's score will be between 0 and 1, with higher scores indicating likely better performance. Final tiers for the outcome assessment are assigned, as shown in Table 1. How can I achieve 100% survival on the summary page, but be ranked at a Tier 4? Both the transplant outcomes on the summary page and the tier assessments are based on 1-year graft survival. But the 5-tier assessments are based on the expected graft survival, specifically the observed versus expected or hazard ratio, which is adjusted. The post-transplant outcomes on the summary page are based on the estimated graft survival, which is unadjusted. The 5-tier assessment for survival on the waiting list is derived from the estimated mortality rate ratio for pre-transplant mortality, as reported in Figure B5 of the PSRs. The mortality rate ratio is a measure of how many patients died before undergoing transplant during the 2-year period evaluated relative to how many were expected to die. The tier for the survival on the waiting list is calculated following exactly the same process as described previously for the 1-year organ survival outcome, but replacing the hazard ratio with the mortality rate ratio. The 5-tier assessment for getting a transplant faster is derived from the estimated transplant rate ratio, as reported in Figure B2D of the program's PSR. For kidney and liver programs, the transplant rate ratio is based on deceased donor-only transplants, as described in the SRTR analytic methods for the program-specific reports. Therefore, this metric provides a measure of the rate at which the program finds deceased donor organs for its candidates. The process for assigning a tier to the transplant rate ratio is the same as described previously with a few minor differences. Unlike the hazard ratio for first-year organ failure and the waitlist mortality rate ratio, in which lower ratios are good, higher transplant rate ratios are good. Therefore, the function used to assign the score to the estimated transplant rate ratio is reversed, such that higher transplant rate ratios yield better scores. In response to requests to review metrics on longer-term transplant outcomes, SRTR is developing reports that will show 5-year outcomes using a period prevalent analytic approach. That metric will also have tiers assigned. It has yet to be determined how SRTR will report this to the public, but stay tuned to our website and social media platforms for updates on these developments. For more specific information on how to use these tools and resources, contact an SRTR representative at srtr@srtr.org.